Hello aviators, and welcome back to Supersonic Flyer, a single platform for all details about AME. In this playlist we will be discussing about Module 3, Electrical Fundamentals. For all those who don't know about modules and modular exams, click on the I icon to see a detailed video on it. Talking about playlist, we will be uploading videos on each and every topic in Module 3, so if you have not subscribed our channel, then please subscribe, and also press the bell icon, so that you never miss a video. So let's get started without wasting time. Today we will discuss about sub-module 1, that is electron theory. So our first topic is matter. Matter can be defined as anything that has weight and occupies space. Matter can be classified in many ways, so let's see one by one the classification of matter. First, let's see classification of matter on the basis of physical state. Matter can be classified in three states of matter, which are solid, liquid, gas. The main difference in properties between these states are: solid have definite mass, definite volume and definite shape, but liquids have definite mass and volume, but takes the shape of container, and gases have definite mass, but occupies the volume of container, and also takes the shape of container. Now let's see classification of matter on the basis of chemical composition. On the basis of chemical composition, matter can be divided into three types: element, compounds, mixture. Talking about each, an element is a substance which cannot be split into two or more chemically simpler substances. Example: hydrogen, oxygen, copper, iron, aluminium, carbon. A compound is a substance which contains two or more elements chemically joined together. Example: water, salt, sulfuric acid. A mixture consists of element or compounds which are brought together by a physical process. Example: salt and sand, earth and sawdust, carbon and iron filings. Now for better understanding, let's see the flowchart. Atom is the smallest constituent particle of matter. Similar atoms combine to form element, element combine to form molecules, and molecules combine to form compound or mixtures. But there is one exception: some element exists monoatomic, so their atom and molecules are same. Example: helium, argon and noble gases. So this was all about matter. Now let's see topic number 2, structure of atom. Some of the important postulates of structure of atom are as follows. Atom is electrically neutral. It contains electron, protons, and neutrons. Electrons travel in an elliptical orbit around nucleus, and protons provide an accessory force to balance the motion. Both protons and neutrons are present in nucleus. Now let's see properties of these particles. First, let's see mass. Mass of proton and neutron is almost same, but mass of electron is 1/1836 times the mass of a proton. Talking about size. Size of proton and neutron is again considered same, but the size of electron is much smaller. Now let's see functions of each particle. First, let's see protons. The number of protons tell us the atomic number, and atomic number helps us to find many other properties of that element. So basically, number of protons determine the type of atom. Now let's see about electrons. The electrons in the orbit defines the size and volume of the atom. Talking about neutrons, they simply add weight to the nucleus. Now let's see topic number 3, electrical materials. So it is one of the basic thing that materials that allow flow of current are conductors, and those that prevent the flow of current are insulators, but they're also exit semiconductors. They have property to partially allow current to flow. We will talk about them in detail later. Some important points to keep in mind are: best electrical conductor is silver, and commonly used conductors are copper and aluminium. So these was the end of topic 3 now. Let's move to last topic for the day, and a very important one. Electron distribution. Some important postulates of this topic are: electrons rotate in shell with fixed energy. Maximum number of electrons in shell is equal to 2n square, where n is equal to shell number. The last shell is valence shell. When atom is influenced by forces like electric field or heat, the valence electrons gain sufficient energy to jump through the forbidden gap into conductor band, where it is free from influence of nucleus. For all those who don't know valence band, forbidden gap, and conduction band, let me tell you that electrons are present in valence bands. If they get energy or force in form of heat and etc., then they jump through the forbidden gap into conduction band, which finally leads to conduction of current. Also keep in mind that in insulators a forbidden gap is long and thus, electron cannot jump from valence band to conduction band, thus, they cannot conduct current. In conductors the valence band and conduction band overlap each other, and thus, electrons and easily jump from valence band to conduction band, thus they can conduct current easily. Talking about semiconductors, the gap is small so, electrons can jump, but they require specific amount of energy. So this was all about submodule 3.1. If you have any doubt or suggestion, then please comment it down. We will surely try to solve it. So that's all for today. If you found the video interesting, then please like the video, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Supersonic Flyer.